Hi, everyone, and welcome back to the show. We're here with a brand new week of the Cabral concept. Couldn't be more excited to be here with you today. Wanted to share with you actually something that happened to me over the past 2 weeks that I've alluded to over the past week or so on the podcast. If you checked out the Friday review, you know what I'm talking about. But simply put, I wanted to share with you the truth and my story of what went on over the past 2 weeks. So just to set the stage, in January of 2020, we're going back a bit now, over 18 months ago, I thought I got COVID. And I didn't think that it was COVID in January of 2020 because, of course, we didn't really know about, nobody's really talking about COVID until March and then April of 2020, 2 to 3 months later. However, we know that the virus was around in January of that year. So I had a fever for 3 days. I was definitely sick. I was overcoming the fever. I had the aches. I had the pains. And then I lost my taste for 2 weeks. So there was no testing back then in January 2020, so I just assumed that that's what I had. It made sense. It was the right time. I had traveled over to Europe just a couple, a month or so prior to that. So I said, okay, you know, I could have easily been exposed in all of my travel to this new virus. And of course, I shared with people, not necessarily that I had it, but what was going on over the past year in the pandemic, and a lot of what I've said, or, you know, and again, I'm not a person to toot my own horn. It's not what I do, but it's played out exactly how we've talked about here on the show. And again, I didn't have any special knowledge ahead of time of how this was going to play out, but it is the history of viruses. So when you look, when you decide to be unbiased and look at the history of viruses and how they progress, we can see exactly what may happen. And that's what I looked at. And for the most part, the good news is that most people recover, and they recover within about 2 weeks' time, a lot of people 3 weeks' time, even if they're healthy. I'm going to go through that today. But this is a serious virus, and I've always said it's a serious virus. And I obviously, my heart goes out to all of those people, whether they had comorbidities or not, that passed away due to this virus. I think it is terrible. There's no doubt about it, especially since we know so much more about the origins of this particular virus now. So my goal is not to come down on Big Pharma, on all the different issues that I believe that that field has and how it's infected a lot of people to this day. But my goal is to simply share with you my story, how I went through it, what I did, how I recovered, and now where I'm moving forward from here. So as I said before, thought I had it, no testing back then. So what did I do? Well, I wasn't careless or anything by any means, but I continued to do a little less travel, of course, because so much was shut down during the lockdown quarantine-based phase. And I wore a mask when I had to wear a mask, and that was it, and basically gone about my business. Well, just about 3 weeks ago, I met up with a few of my team members, and one was coming from California, another one coming from another part of the U.S., and one of them had contracted COVID, essentially, on the way to the meeting. I felt okay, no issues, and then about a week later, I said, oh, I'm starting to feel tired. I'm starting to feel some joint pain, some aches, some pains, very mild fever. Let me get tested. And so I got tested right away that day. I was positive. I said, okay, let me get another test just to make sure. So that was an official one at a wellness-based clinic where they come out to the car, they do the swab, all of that. And then I did another home-based kit. They were both positive. So I said, okay, you know, I have it. My family's been around me the last couple of days. We're going to quarantine. So we quarantined for 2 weeks together just to make sure. Again, I take this very seriously for other people's health. At no point was I necessarily worried for my health or my children's health, my wife's health. But of course, I'm always looking after my family, and I'll make sure that I need to do whatever they need in order to stay healthy. So what happened to me was essentially 3 days of a low-grade fever. You can qualify that however you'd like, but basically it was below 100. So it was like 99.5, 99.8. And that's what I had. And I had some aches and some pains, but mainly fatigue. Mainly exhaustion, fatigue, and low appetite. So after about 3 or 4 days, the aches and the pains went away, and I was feeling like I was on the mend. I still continued to quarantine. I was working the whole time. So the thing is, I have a home office, and the home office allows me to, basically quarantine away from other people, still able to do my work, but I kept my work at a minimum. So basically, whatever I had to get done for my team and my companies, I made sure to do that. I still did my recordings. That's why if I sounded a little like I was, you know, like grabbing for words, for sure I was, because I'm never going to lie to you on the podcast. I'm always going to give you the truth. And I was tired. There's no doubt about it. I had fatigue. It was weird. It felt like I was back 20 years ago during my Epstein-Barr virus, during my chronic fatigue syndrome, Addison's, myalgic encephalomyelitis. So it brought me back to some dark times. There's just no doubt about it. And I don't like that feeling. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't like being tired or exhausted, because I'm not then my best, and I can't show up as my best in life for everybody else. So I definitely was not my best for my team. Like I had, I was just not able to be at my best in terms of my thinking, clarity, or any of the different direction or anything else that I try to provide my team. And for my two daughters, my wife and I were tired. We were wiped out. So we were sleeping whenever possible. So I was laying down on my couch when I got home at night. And my daughters are not used to seeing me lie down on the couch. And I was going to bed by 8:30 every single night. And I would sleep till about 6:30 a.m. So I was getting in about 10 hours of sleep per night. But again, you have to do that to continue to rejuvenate your body. But I haven't done that since I was, you know, in my early 20s, trying to overcome those viruses and Addison's disease and POTS and all these other things back then. So it brought me back definitely to a darker place, a place that I never wanted to revisit. Is it? But I kept going back in my mind, and that's why this show is on a Mindset of Motivation Monday, because we're all going to face hardships in our life. There's no doubt about it. And I don't want to compare my COVID story with anybody else's. Mine was pretty mild. There's just no doubt about that. 3 or 4 days, aches, pains, flu-like symptoms, and then fatigue for about another week or so, definitely. And then still, you know, like I'm at 90%+ 2 weeks later. And so I don't ever want to compare my story, which is very mild, to many other people that have had to be hospitalized, or of course worse. So my all I can share with you is this though, is, and I wanted to do this on the Mindset of Motivation Monday because it brought me back to a place when I was very sick and I had no hope back then. But now I brought to this situation a new mindset and a new understanding that I try to do, that I would like you to do as well. And that's that we've been here before. Meaning, like, when you are in a difficult position in life, a lot of times you can draw back and say, I've been here before. And that's what I said to myself. Listen, I'm tired today. I don't know if this is going away tomorrow. I'm exhausted, but I'm going to get through it. I'm going to get through it. That I know that I'm going to recover. I've recovered before from harsher illnesses. I will recover from this as well. Now, you don't want to be careless with that mindset, especially if you have comorbidities, especially if you're 65 plus, right? So you don't want to be careless, but you can't let your mind go to a place that you are already defeated. And the research is actually backing this up as well. Part of my de-stress protocol that I write about in the Rain Barrel Effect is not just emotional balance, but a success mindset. You have to have the mindset that even if today is not a good day, that tomorrow could be better, and it most likely will get better. So with COVID, a lot of times, like, your symptoms are a little bit different each day. Some days it might be joint pain. Another day it's brain fog. It might be a headache. I had a really debilitating headache one day out of the blue, random. Okay, now we need to overcome that. Tomorrow, maybe I won't have a headache. It'll be a better day. That's what we're always telling ourselves. And then you start to feel a little bit better and a little bit better because you're taking care of yourself or you're getting any needed medications for yourselves as needed. Now, I know, again, I quarantined for 2 weeks. I take it very seriously. I didn't even pick up like mail or packages. I actually had a package returned to sender because I didn't go to the mailroom to pick up mail. And that's what I chose to do. And I felt it was the right thing. My family, of course, they got it as well. Were they happy about it? No, not at all. But here is the thing. We also now have the... So there's always a silver lining if you choose to see the silver lining. We all now have our own natural immunity, which we know is 10 to 13 times stronger than anything else that you do for your body. So it was the right, it wasn't, there's not necessarily a right or wrong because it is what it is. I contracted the virus, but now my kids, by the way, and just to let you know, they were sick for maybe a 24 hours to 36 hours. And all they had was a low grade fever, about a 99.5, a little bit of lethargy, a little less appetite. And that was it. You wouldn't really know they had it. Honestly, you wouldn't really know they had it unless you know your kids, of course, and you can see that they're a little less energetic. So that's it. But they still got their immune protocol. I did it for an entire 10 days for them. And my wife and I are still on mine. Now, again, I can't give you any medical advice. I'm not providing you a treatment protocol. And of course, always seek out medical attention. But people will always ask, you know, what I did. And I did exactly what I've laid out as the full virus protocol before. So every single day, I take my daily foundational protocol. I'm not even going to go through all of what that is today, but it's daily nutritional support shake, daily fruit and vegetable blend, my omega-3s, daily probiotic. That's it. You know, it's very simple, very straightforward. Take your enzymes with your meals. But then every day, since this pandemic, I've also been doing the immunity protocol. So it's balanced zinc, it's vitamin D, and it is alkalizing vitamin C. And I do that every single day. So in addition, what did I do? I doubled my immunity protocol. Daily foundational protocol stays exactly the same. What did I do? I doubled my vitamin C to 5 grams per day in divided doses. I took my vitamin D, typically it's at 4,000 IUs, and for 3 weeks, again, I've doubled this for 3 weeks, it's going to 8,000 IUs. For my zinc went from getting 15 grams in my daily nutritional support plus another 15 grams in the balanced zinc. What am I doing? I'm adding on more zinc and I'm getting another 15 to 30 grams per day. And the only other item I added was the sinus support. And the sinus support, I added that not because I had any congestion or really any cough at all. I did have some difficulty breathing a couple of days. I won't say that I didn't. It felt like if you've ever gone for a run, I used to be a runner way back in the day, but if you've ever gone to run on a cold day, it feels like you're breathing in cold air. That's the only way I could describe it. It's like hard to get that deep breath in. It lasted a couple of days and that was gone. But one of the reasons why I take the sinus support is that it has licorice root in it and it has thyme. Well, we won't get into the thyme today. And it has N-acetylcysteine and it has higher dosages. So I took 1 to 2 of those capsules 3 times a day. So since I had a lowered appetite, my afternoon shake went away and I was doing my breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That's it. And I was taking those products at those 3 meals. One more item that I wanted to insert that I actually forgot to mention that's really important as I shared with you my personal COVID-based protocol, again, not a medical advice-based protocol that I'm giving you, is that in addition to the Equal Life daily foundational protocol that I use every day and the immunity protocol, which I essentially double when I'm going through some type of viral-based issue. So that's 5 grams total of vitamin C. That is 50 to 75 total milligrams of zinc every day. And then 8,000 IUs. I typically do 4,000 IUs of vitamin D, which is 4 drops. I doubled that to 8 for just 2 to 3 weeks. And then I shared with you, I also use the sinus support. And the sinus support is 1 to 2 capsules at breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Now, the other item that I forgot to mention, which is one of those products that I literally use every day, but I increase it when I have a viral-based issue, and that's HIST Pro. One of the amazing ingredients inside of His Pro. Now, there are many. There are stinging nettles, there's bromelain, there's so many great ingredients. But the star is actually quercetin. And quercetin, I've spoken about on this podcast before because it's known as a zinc ionophore, which means it helps zinc get into the cells and the tissues to a greater degree where a lot of these viruses are hidden, and it helps to actually then unravel the viruses and destroy the viral-based replication. And again, that is clinically proven. So quercetin helps to get that zinc in there. That's why I use the His Pro, and the His Pro is 3 capsules at breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So 3 capsules, 3 times a day, and then typically on a daily basis, I'm taking 3 to 4 capsules every single day, which is great for someone like myself with previous history of allergies and histamine-based issues. So again, I use the Equalife Foundation Protocol every day. I use the immunity Protocol every day. I double it when I have a virus. I switch my His Pro to 3 capsules 3 times a day. And then for sinus support for 3 weeks, I use 1 to 2 capsules at all 3 meals for the day. So hopefully that's helpful. So that's what I did. I'm still doing it this week as well as I'm getting back to 100%. But one of the reasons why I want to do this on this Monday show is that I shared with you about 4 weeks ago on episode 2057. That I had a specific body transformation goal. Not that I needed to do anything new, but I was excited. I was excited about getting back to the gym, lifting a little heavier. I added an extra shake in the afternoon. I mean, I was good to go. And then about 2 weeks later, just like that, boom, you know, energy starts to go. I obviously get this virus. And now what? Well, I'm out of the gym for 2 weeks. And believe it or not, and I'm not happy to admit this, I actually wasn't doing my morning bodyweight exercises. And for me, not to do my morning bodyweight exercises every single day of the week is, it takes a lot. I was thinking back, I'm like, when have I ever missed a day? And it was years ago, literally years ago. So that's how I knew, like, okay, you can. And why did I do it though? Because I had to conserve energy. I had to play it smart. And I also said to myself, listen, this is temporary, right? You have to use that success mindset. This is temporary. This is not going to continue. We've been here before. We will be back. We'll be back stronger. That's what I kept saying to myself. So you need to give yourself time. But in the meantime, I had just put on 2 to 3 pounds of muscle, didn't even add any extra body fat. I was looking forward to all of these different gym workouts. What did I do? Not only did I lose that 2 to 3 pounds, I lost another 4 pounds. So when you look at it, it's discouraging, right? It's frustrating for any of us to move backwards on our goals. And that's also why I wanted to share with this with you this week as well. So this week I am back at the gym, but I'm not at that 100% capacity. Could I? Yes, I could, but that wouldn't be a smart decision. The pitta in me wants to get back 100%, get right back in the same exercises, get right back to using the heavier weights, but it's not a great idea because my body is still rebuilding now. It's recharging after a 2-week fight with a particular virus, right? So it's re-energizing, it's recharging, it's rejuvenated. I'm back to the gym, and what I'm doing is about 2/3 of my workout that I was doing before. So I'm practicing what I preach. I am taking my own medicine, as they say. I brought it from 3 sets down to 2 sets, and I'm doing about 80% of the weights that I used to do. So that will enable me to say, how do you feel this week? How do you feel the next day? Are you inflamed? Are you not inflamed? And instead of doing 2 days in a row and a day off and then 2 days in a row, what I'm doing is every other day. So I'm giving a full day for that inflammation to be squelched and for me to be able to then use that for repair. So is it where I want to be? No, but we have to understand we have both the marathon mentality and the sprint mentality. I am truly born a sprinter, meaning like I love seeing a problem and trying to overcome the challenge. I honestly do enjoy that, but now that would not be a smart decision in this case. So sometimes we need to take a step back for our own good and say, listen, I'm going to be in this for the next 50, 60 years. We need to step back. We need to realize that this is also a marathon as well. And again, you might be frustrated now, but you've been here before. and you're already feeling yourself begin to get that strength back, that stamina back. There's no more aches. There's no more pains. There's no more breathing issues. There's none of that. Continue to get extra sleep. Continue to go to bed a little bit earlier. Keep taking your immunity protocol. Keep taking your daily foundational protocol. Do the things that you would do to overcome any type of health-based issue, even if you're already feeling well. Continue to add surplus to the body. Continue to bring in more energy than you give out. So I just wanted to share with you that, listen, I'm always doing my best. I really am. But anybody can contract this virus. Anybody can get sick. So it's not that you can't. I always wanted to relay that to you. I typically get maybe 2 to 3 colds per year. And I do a lot of travel. So it doesn't mean that I can never get sick. What it means is, how do you recover? A healthy body can get sick, because the illness is simply your immune system, your white blood cells giving off symptoms of it fighting the virus, or it fighting any virus or any bacterial-based infection. So now what we're doing is we're saying, how well do you recover? So I want to make sure my recovery leaves me in an even stronger position with stronger antibodies, rebuilding up my stamina, balancing back inflammation, and realizing, because I haven't been sick in a long time. I mean, it was since the January before that I had really been sick. I had like a 24-hour to maybe 48-hour thing earlier in the summer when I did some travel, and then it was gone. So it was no big deal. But this is the first time since January 2020. So again, it's been like, more than 18 months, right? 20 months or something like that, that I got sick. And again, I don't think it's any badge of honor to never get sick at all. People have different immune systems as well. I've also talked about TH2 versus TH1 immunity, but it's understanding that we're going to come under challenges and hardships, those types of things in our life. We need to make sure we maintain a success mindset. Even if I was someone with comorbidity, 65 plus, and even if you felt yourself declining a little bit, I've talked about medical intervention before. That's not a loss. That is not a loss. You do what you need to do in order to continue the marathon. So if you need to take certain pharmaceuticals when you are not doing well and declining, you should do that. You should do whatever you need to do to keep you in this game. So don't ever think that I do things one way, this person does want things one way, so you need to do it that way. You need to do whatever is best for your body, but what I need you to have is the success mindset that you're going to overcome this, that it's not bigger than you, that you will seek out all the advice and medical-based attention or health-based protocols that you need in order to overcome this and anything in your future. And then if you overcome this and you have comorbidities, heart issues, blood pressure issues, blood sugar issues, autoimmune issues, obesity, whatever it is, use this as a catalyst to say, I'm going to overcome those as well. So when the next virus comes around, my body is going to be even stronger and in better position to be able to fight that off. And overall, on an everyday lifestyle spectrum, you're going to have more energy, more vitality, more ambition, more drive for life. And that's really what it's all about. So again, I just simply wanted to share with you, I don't want to say my story is anything different than anybody else's, any worse than anyone else's, any better than anyone else's. Everybody goes through this virus in their own particular way. We now know that most people are going to get this, whether they've done any medical-based interventions or not. The goal is to simply say, okay, if I get it, I get it. I'm going to overcome it. I'm going to give my body the diet, exercise, stress reduction, right? The toxin removal, all these things that it needs in order to be its best self, to ramp up that antibody production so those antibodies destroy the antigen, they destroy the virus, and allow you in the end to be an even healthier individual. That's what I hope for you. I apologize if I left anything out on this show. I am happy to take your questions. And again, This show wasn't meant to offend anyone. It wasn't meant to say one side is right, one side is wrong, or even medical intervention is not better or better than any type of natural health-based protocols. My goal is to always get you to understand that your mindset, your ability to believe in yourself will ultimately allow you to make the best decisions for you and get the help that you need, again, whether it be natural health or conventional medicine, to overcome anything that stands in your path. So I appreciate you taking the time to listen to this. I really do. I'm happy to answer any questions and glad to be feeling great again. I really am. And again, like I said, hopefully that someone can find some inspiration in this. And of course, if you feel it was helpful, please do feel free to share it with anyone else you believe it could serve. Take care, everyone. Have an amazing day.